The Attorney General Barr of the United States has been a target for an avalanche of media attacks recently. After the decision to drop charges against Michael Flynn, NBC, the news station, thought the best way to convince everyone that AG Barr is a really bad man was to edit out his real answer in an interview. But they got caught, and in today's video, we will take a look at how exactly that happened.
I want you to listen to this Bill Barr answer to a question about what will history say about this. Wait till you hear this answer. Take a listen.
When history looks back on this decision, how do you think it will be written?
Well, history is written by the winner, so it largely depends on who's writing the history.
I was struck, Peggy, by the cynicism of the answer. It's a correct answer, but he's the Attorney General. He didn't make the case that he was upholding the rule of law.
Yes, Chuck, who covers politics all day long, was struck by the cynicism, and he was really saddened that the AG Barr didn't mention the rule of law in the interview. Oh, but actually he did. In the full interview, not the one-line edited version that NBC chose to throw out. Take a look at this.
When history looks back on this decision, how do you think it will be written?
Well, history is written by the winner, so it largely depends on who's writing the history. But I think a fair history would say it was a good decision because it upheld the rule of law.
He's saying that it was a good decision because it upheld the rule of law. So what really annoys me about this clip is that we are seeing it far too often. It happens all the time. And the media doesn't seem to care that they're doing this all while having the lowest ratings of trust by their audiences in history. Politics has become such a team sport now that journalists are going out of their way to misrepresent someone just because they ideologically or politically disagree with them. Sometimes they outright lie. This is what you expect to see in a kindergarten, not by professional news people. Look, there are plenty of reasons for journalists to criticize governments, but they have to do so fairly and constructively instead of poisoning everyone with deceptive attacks. So this article from realclearpolitics.com dives into this very issue, and it mostly talks about the media's democratic ties, but in general, it goes both for the right and for the left. So let's read on from down here. During the Obama administration, many members of the media floated in and out of the administration and in and out of left-wing blogs and think tanks. They are still around, with many of them serving as reporters and their left-wing friends as active members of the Democrats' resistance. They trade information and shape each other's worldviews, and I am not convinced the heads of media outlets are doing enough to push their reporters to separate their worldview from the facts at hand. As a result, we are not getting the whole truth, but a narrative within which facts are shaped to advance the narrative. This is exactly what I wanted to address in today's video, that the media has become too aligned with the political parties, especially in America right now. It goes on to read, there's a pretty substantial symbiotic relationship between the political left in Washington and the media. While a few people went from the media to the Bush administration, it was never like it was with Obama. So it goes on to name a long list of people that are tied to the Democratic Party who went to work for newspapers or the other way around. And as I said before, this isn't just an issue with the Democrats and the media. It's the same with the Republicans and the media. So you might know about someone like Congressman Jason Chaffetz, who now works as a contributor to the Fox News. Also names like James Clapper and John Brennan and James Comey, they all work as CNN contributors right now. And these were people who were former heads of intelligence agencies or law enforcement agencies. I could go on and on as the list of names increase every single day, but I think you kind of get the point. Another story that really stands out to me is the time when Roger Stone, the former advisor to Donald Trump, got his house raided in the middle of the night, or early morning at least. What was important is that CNN had a cameraman conveniently standing outside ready to film when the SWAT teams drive up next to his car and raid the house. They don't say anything to him. We have camera footage of this. And CNN obviously knew something was going to happen. So you kind of get the sense that there's communication between the law enforcement agencies and these news outlets, which goes against everything that we stand for. Alright guys, I make videos like these every single day covering the undercover international news stories. So remember to hit me with a subscribe so you don't miss out on tomorrow's videos and the future videos. Thank you very much for watching the full video. Have a great day.